Hello everyone, this is Edmund Bradford and in this short series of videos we're going to be talking about sustainable consumer behaviour. Now we hear a lot in the media about the power of customers and how they can influence good corporate sustainable behaviour by companies and by brands and brand managers. And in this series of videos we're going to be exploring that subject in a little more deeply. I'm going to be looking at what it is, which consumers are sustainable and which ones aren't, and what insights companies can learn from the discussion, how they can apply any insights that we bring up. So to help me with all of that, I've got my good friend and colleague, Dr. Alina Udall. Now she's a lecturer at Warwick Business School. In fact, we're colleagues at Warwick Business School. She's also a research fellow at Newcastle University, both in the UK. And she has a PhD and a particular interest in this issue of sustainable consumer behaviour. So hello, Alina, and thank you for joining us.
Hello, Ed. Really, thank you for inviting me here today.
It's my pleasure. And so the first thing I think we should do really is just understand the issue, just understand what we're talking about. So when we talk about sustainable consumer behaviour, Alina, I assume we're talking more than just picking up, you know, Coca-Cola bottles or whatever from the beach. We're talking about something a bit more significant now. What do we mean by sustainable consumer behaviour?
So most broadly, sustainable consumer behaviour can be defined as, or we define it at least in our papers, as those behaviours that aim to preserve the environment, prevent damage to the environment, or promote the well-being to the environment, such as the consumer sort of not buying products that have packaging, for example, which is the new way forward that companies are looking to change their behaviours, but also in your homes, like reducing your water use. And in essence, not consuming is one of the biggest things. Not consuming, as the United Nations rightly said a long time ago in 1987, they said basically sustainability is meeting the needs of the present without compromising the ability of future generations to meet their own needs. And that merely is sort of saying that we don't want to do behaviours that potentially impact the future generations that then have to pick up the fallout of what we are doing.
Yeah, so I like that. I like that definition. I think it's a really simple definition, isn't it? Do you want to just repeat that, Alina? That United Nations definition?
Yeah, of course. It's
repeat that, yeah?
Yeah, meeting the needs of the present, so now, without compromising the ability of future generations to also meet their own needs.
So in terms of consumer behaviour, it's behaving today in a way that does not jeopardize our future. Is that right? Yeah.
That's exactly right. Yeah. And consumer behavior would generally be considered maybe a subset of sustainability, because it does heavily rely on those behaviors, such as what you were saying, how we behave in shops and how we consume products and services. So it does tend to be on the consumerism side. However, in sustainability, or also synonymous would be pro-environmental behaviour, we often really regard pro-environmental behaviour or sustainability, or even sustainable consumer behaviour, more generally looking at the whole supply chain as well as the end consumers uptaking those products. So nowadays it's considered that sustainable consumer behavior is not necessarily just focusing on the consumption, and it's actually focusing on the whole life cycle of, say, a product. That's really important, because we need to look at the impact of that. And I don't know if you noticed in the definition that I provided earlier on, that what I did mention was that those behaviors that aim to prevent damage or promote the well-being or preserve the planet, because actually sustainability is quite complicated. And when you do get a product, there's lots of things involved in that process. So it's not it's the ideal we're looking for. We're aiming to do that, but it might not always be as clear cut when you think about it. Mm. Sort of buying oat milk, for example, is a really good behaviour. It's considered, it's going vegan, which is considered a really good life choice in terms of sustainability. But then if you're consuming loads of packaging as a result of that, then also you have to think about, well, how sustainable would that be? Oh. So it's quite a balancing act, actually, thinking about what behaviours are suitable or not suitable.
Yeah, and it's a big subject. I mean, it's a massive subject. And so I think from what you say, first of all, in this area that we're talking about, it's everything from choice of product or service, at one end, all the way through to how you use it and how you dispose of it at the other end.
Yes, and
as you say, it's not just about the end consumer. The subject also covers, maybe you call them customers rather than consumers, but it also covers customers all the way up and down the supply chain. That's the area that we're interested in. So we're trying to generate the right demand signals, if you like, all the way through that supply chain to encourage good behavior from suppliers all the way up to the original primary raw material providers.
Definitely agree with the way you put that. That's really nice. Yes.
And just on the terms, before we finish this little part, Alina, just mm-hmm. out of interest. So you mentioned their pro-environmental behaviour. Can we use that interchangeably with sustainable consumer behaviour? Are there any other terms that tend to be used, like ecological consumerism and that kind of thing? Are they kind of fairly interchangeable?
You can use those very interchangeably. Another term, for example, has been used by Kaiser and colleagues that actually state that it's called potentially ecological behaviour, general ecological behaviour. The way in which us as psychologists or environmental psychologists define it depends on often how we also operationalise it. So, for example, if you look at one of my first papers that I did on sustainability, it's a systematic review, and I actually talk quite heavily on how the concept of environmental behavior, as well as the concepts that we use in order to understand that, for example, how we see ourselves, that in the literature there are so many terms often used to refer to the same thing. And what people are trying to do is try and narrow that down in order to get a general consensus of what is the broad thing that we're referring to. And I still agree with that definition that we started out with in 1987. It's, we have sustainability, and the idea is that we just have sub categories based on how we are using that definition.
Terrific. Thanks, Alina. And what it comes down to, of course, is education, isn't it? It's educating the consumer. The more educated the consumer or the customers are right the way through that supply chain about this complex issue, that the better able they are to make the right sort of choices. So I'll leave it there, Alina. So thank you very much for that. Now, in the next sort of little interview, we'll talk a bit more about, are consumers actually sustainable or not? So thanks very much, Alina, and I look forward to speaking to you again soon.
Thank you.